is Shika, and I come today because I just, you know, want to give you a little rundown, basically what my channel is about. I'm going to be doing a lot of vlogging, you know, just about my everyday life, that sort of thing. Like, I'm going to do makeup tutorials, etc. It's just so much stuff, like, I want to dive into or that I want to share with you guys. And this is my first time, you know, this is my first video, that I'm putting on YouTube. I'm actually out here letting my kids play in the yard. So, just to give you a little rundown about me, I'm 27, I was born December 1st, 1992. I have two beautiful daughters, the age of 8 and 4. House, car, you know, normal life. Recently, I just lost my mom, and that was a really hard day for me. Well, it was a really hard night because I got the news late one night. I was babysitting, and you know, the kids was up playing, and I was just, you know, at this time we was, you know, they was all bedding down or whatever, and I went in bed to try to put the baby to sleep, and you know, probably about 35, probably to an hour of the baby being asleep, my cousin came and got the baby, and you know, like, so at this point I know, like, I can go ahead, settle down, relax, watch some TV before I, you know, go to sleep. So if you see me looking off, I'm looking at the kids. So when I was, you know, getting ready to lay down and get prepared to go to sleep, I heard like a banging at my door. It was a really loud banging, and I thought it was the police, honestly, because it was one of those knocks that you could not ignore. Like, you really could not ignore this type of knock. And so it was my sister. So I looked at my friend, and I was looking like, wonder who is that at my door? And so we was both puzzled, like, who is that at your door, like, this time of morning? Like, it was like, you know, one something, like, who is this knocking at your door? So anyway, it was my sister, and you know, she was so broken. Like, she was really hurt. I'm back. So yes, so she was really heartbroken. She was, you know, she was just all over the place. She was basically trying to tell me that my mom's boyfriend called and said that my mom passed away. Like, my mom, you know, she didn't make it. And so hearing that news, I instantly felt numb. Like, the cry that I wanted to cry couldn't even come out, because I've been through some hurtful stuff, and it doesn't have me bitter. You know, I just know how cold the world can be. So it's just like losing somebody, you know, that you love, or losing somebody close to you, losing somebody important. It's like a different type of hurt. And all the hurt I done been through in my life, it has been different. It has been a different type of hurt. So, I don't know. I just couldn't, you know, break down, or I guess I did it in my own way. I don't know. I know I just really wanted to do something for the last time for my mom, because when I got that news, like, I'm telling you, like, my mom was sick. Like, she had a heart condition. So she had a lung disease, she had a heart disease. And so, you know, that was my best friend. Like, that was my best friend. Like, seriously, that's my best friend. So, like, something just said to me, like, when she was here, something just said to me, you know, just, because we had been through so much. And something just told me, you know, get your mom and, you know, see if she want to come, you know, spend some time with you and your kids. Even though I know she would, because, you know, she love her grandkids. But, you know, it's just staying the night, because that would have been her first time actually staying the night with me in my new apartment. So, yeah, so she was down. She was like, yeah, you know, you're going to be cooking for me. And I was like, yeah. I was like, you know, I'm going to be cooking. So anyway, she came and she stayed like a whole week. Mind you, I pampered my mom, like, meaning, you know, her foot got swelled up because she had a lung disease. So that means the fluid would back up in her lungs. So with that being said, it would, you know, cause like her foot to swell. It would cause her to have breathing problems. Like, you know, she would just have it bad some days and stuff. And, you know, some days she was, you know, good and stuff. But, still, you know, when I find out, not that my mom was sick, but I don't know, it was just like something triggered in me, because I got on this natural journey, and I really feel like it was inspired by my mom unconsciously thinking, because I don't know how I just come to God on that, you know, natural journey, of, you know, just like barely wanting to take medication, like any type of medication. Like, I really look into natural herbs, you know, just a lot of natural supplements and stuff like that that'll help you and that are more good for you than prescription or, you know, over-the-counter medicine, whatever. But anyway, I will always tell my mom about this, and she would be like, you know, but I gotta take my medicine, you know, I gotta take my steroids, because if I don't, then my bones, you know, they will get sore, like, she would get weak and stuff like that. So I understood it, and I said, I understand, Mom. I was like, you know, we're not gonna script you from them, we're just gonna wean you off of them. And, you know, with her having that heart disease, you know, she still couldn't take certain things. So still, like, I try to change, like, not change her eating habit, but still make some of the things she loved, but just healthier. And, I just, you know, really, 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 really try to get my mom right, because that's really what she wanted. She really wanted to be healthy for her grandkids, for us. You know, she really loved life. You couldn't box her in. Anyway, you know, but like I was saying, I pampered her, like, I bathed her feet, like, I rubbed her feet, helped her to the bed, helped her to the bathroom, you know, I was just, you know, cook for her, just everything. Like, I just really wanted her to know, like, she was special, not just because she was my mom, you know, just because she had been through so much. And I'm not gonna say, like, she always looked for that validation, but she really always looked for that validation, you know, to say, you know, good job, or, I don't know, I guess to be uplifted, like, you know, everybody loved that uplifted, because then you start wondering, like, you know, I just feel like if you're not gonna really uplift somebody and be a positive role model, a positive, vibe, a positive force in their life, I really don't see the need for you to even be there. Like, that's just how I am with my life. Like, especially, like, since I got so close to my mom and my mom passed, no, like, you really have to earn my presence. Like, and it's not being conceited, it's just, like, the world is really tainted, first of all. It's really evil. And not saying that, you know, whatever, but the world is really evil. So, when I go to just to think about, you know, my mom, she just couldn't be boxed in. Like, I'm telling you, like, no matter how sad she was, no matter how unhappy she was, like, she really tried to make everybody happy. She really tried to, you know, just keep and put a smile on everybody's face. It was just, I guess, something that she loved doing. Like, that was just her, like, and, you know, I would be the one to her, you know, like, sometimes you really got to treat people the way they treat you, you know, like, so they can really see and feel how that really feel. Like, it doesn't feel good. And she would just always tell me, let me be me. Shika, let me be me. And that's just her, like, I'm telling you. But anyway, like, y'all, when I had got that news, like, that crushed me. That really broke my heart. It broke my heart because I was not expecting it. Like, nobody was expecting that, first of all. She just came back from the beach with my grandmother, her mother, from staying with her brother, her only brother, her baby brother. And because he just had his second child, which is another little boy. And, you know, she went down there to see him and spend time with him and stuff like that. So, just to know, like, you know, she passed away, like, few hours later, basically, not a few, but, you know, like 6, 7, 8, 9 hours later. That was still a big shocker for us because we wasn't expecting it, and it just came out the blue. Like, and you know, I was already preparing myself for this because, like I said, I already knew my mom was sick, and God already kept telling me, like, don't take it as a joke. Like, even though she's doing what she's doing, meaning she's going out, she's doing her thing, she's drinking, whatever, whatever. She's doing her thing. Like I said, I wasn't but the boxer. And live your life, babe. Live your life. And she really, really taught me that, like, to live my life. Like, and that don't mean be out here going doing crazy things. It's just do what makes me happy. No matter what. That's just really how I feel, you know? Do what makes me happy because I only get one life. No matter if, you know, something happened, God forbid, and he give me a second chance, like, I still only get one life, you know, to do what I love or to be me. So, with my mom transitioning, like, I remember telling my girls the news, and my baby, Nala, like, my little girl, like, she is, like, so close to my mom. And to be honest, I really think she was closer, you know, to my mom in a different way, like, in a different way. Like, she was, I don't know, like, she was my mom's sensitive spot. I don't know, like, my mom was already sensitive, but, like, Nala was her sensitive spot, if that makes sense. I don't know, because she felt it. Like, she, like, when I told them the news, the way she took it, like, she internalized it emotionally, like, and it really showed, like, she got sick. She caught a fever. She didn't want to eat. You know, it was around Thanksgiving time. My dad came down, you know, for Thanksgiving, whatever, like, she wasn't happy to see my dad. Not saying that she wasn't happy, but it just wasn't showing. Like, so I just, you know, as a mother, and I paid close attention to my kids. I just really paid attention. You know, like, my oldest, she knew. And I asked him what it meant. I asked him, I said, you know, what it means when somebody passed away, you know, like, when somebody died and don't come back. They're gone forever. My oldest said, it means like they're in a hospital. And I'm thinking she's saying that because, you know, like, my mom, she always been, like, in and out the hospital. And so I'm thinking she's thinking of that. But Nyla, she said, it means you're in heaven. So, you know, I told them about it. If you like to see that video, you know, please let me know, because I don't, you know, want to, I don't want to just, that was my aunt. I don't want to just, even though I'm going to put, my journey up and basically like my experience just really on my mom. It's not to offend nobody. It's not to make nobody, like, you know, scared or anything. Like, it was just a major connection. It was major closure for me because, for one, let me know if you want to see that video of me telling my girls the news of my mom passing. And just the conversation on that. It's just a little clip. Like I said, I'm going to really insert it just so y'all can still see it. And, you know, y'all can just get in tune more with me, because I'm telling you, like, when I went to sleep, probably like 2 days after, like when I woke up, something like literally told me, not something, like it was just in my spirit, like to do my mom makeup for the last time. Like, she rarely got makeup now. Like, she wasn't a makeup person. She wasn't like a weed type of girl like she was back then, like, you know, in her younger days. But she loved her cut, you know, with her nice curl kit, like, not curl kit because she was natural, but, you know, she used to spray a little water on it or whatever and let the curls start popping. But she had loved her cut, and she had loved, you know, colors. Like, she had loved colors. My mom was bright. She was bright, man. She was bright. She was very energetic. She was very loving, caring. Like, I don't know. She was just so much. So, like, when she passed, I really felt and I really feel that she released something into the universe that I felt inside of me. And I'm not saying that to be crazy. I'm not saying it to be funny. Like, it's the honest feeling that I felt, like, of the funeral of my mom. Like, I honestly felt of the funeral, like, the energy of the funeral, the energy of, nothing was negative, nothing was bad. Like, my mom's funeral was so beautiful. Like, it was so beautiful. I'm telling you, y'all, like, my mom was nothing but love. She was nothing but love. And yeah, she would talk her shit, and she would tell you what it is. And, you know, that'll just be that. And she would let you have it, but not in a nasty way, not to, you know, basically try to tear you down, anything. Like, she just wasn't that type of person. She would just really always keep it real with you. The energy was just so, 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 so crazy. It was just like, I don't know. Hold on, guys. My daughter. Okay. But don't do that no more. But, I'm not, like, I was hurt, you know, because my mom is not here. I can't call her. Like, we used to talk every day. Like, I have bookloads of text messages. Like, me and my mom always talk. So, the thing is, it was just like, I know she wasn't hurting anymore. Like, I know she wasn't suffering, like, mentally, emotionally, and physically. Like, I just really know God called her home. Like, I'm just kind of giving you a little rundown. You see, that didn't really went much into how my mom died. You know, where she was at, the exact time, like, just, you know, the day, just none of that. Like, I just really didn't went into details because I'm not sure how you guys would actually feel, but I just really want to share that with you guys, because that's a really, really, really important part of me. Like, I just, I'm gonna keep it. I'm gonna keep it because not only that I wanted to do her makeup. Like, I followed through with it. I actually got ready. And I went. And I went. And I pushed myself to block out my emotions. Not to not be there, but to hold it together and to be able to do what I knew I wanted to do. To do what I wanted to fulfill that. Not just for me, but for her, because I think she wanted me to do that. I don't know. But I just know, you know, she's in a better place. And it's really still fresh. It's really still fresh, but I just really want to share it. Because, like, you know, my sisters, like, they're scared to watch it. So I don't blame them, because they're maybe not ready for that. But I just want to be able to vent and be able to share it. You know, just get it off. Not off of me, because it is off of me, but I want to be able to, you know, really talk about it. So, I just really love her. And I just really cherish the woman that she became, you know, before she transitioned. She was just so, so beautiful. And, you know, everybody will say their mom is beautiful, but my mom was really like a shining light, yo. I'm telling you. She was really a shining light from God. And I feel it. Like, I really feel her. Like I said, I'm not hurt. I'm not angry. You know, I'm not trying to question God or anything. Like, because I feel good. I'm happy that my mom is not suffering anymore. Because I'm telling you, I remember so many nights, like, my mom used to call me because she was having trouble breathing. And she would call me late night because, you know, I will always, you know, pick up that phone and just go to, you know, Google was my best friend, really. And I would just always go to look up my natural remedies, or, you know, look up natural things for this problem. And, you know, I would just always really try to, you know, she would be on the phone with me, and I would tell her how to do it. And, you know, I would stay on the phone until she'd do it to see how she really felt. And it was just, you know, I was really in tune with my mom. Like, I'm telling you, I was really in tune with my mom. So I was really trying to get her right. That's why I take my vitamins daily. I take my vitamins faithfully. I'm telling you. Like, I have really seen a difference in my body, physically, inside and out. Emotionally, like, I just can process things a whole lot differenter. And I just really feel, you know, I really feel good. I really feel good. And my mom is she's a really big piece of that. She's a really big part of that, you know, the way how I feel. And me just going so hard, and what am I doing, or what am I trying to do? And that's really stay healthy, and, you know, raise two beautiful, healthy girls. But the funeral was amazing. So, guys, I just wanted to give you a little rundown of me. Like I said, I'm Shika, and, you know, this is basically gonna be like a story time channel, blogging, you know, you just kicking it with me, you know, you just vibing with me every, you know, just vibing with me hard and strong, seriously, because I always wanted to do YouTube, but I just kept pushing it off. Like, honestly, like, I kept pushing it off. So with me pushing it off, it just, I'm just like, China, stop. I'm just really trying to focus on, you know, me and my girls and happiness, just pure happiness and peace and love and tranquility. You know, I just really,
I wonder how you pass by. She said, hey.
Yeah, no, I had waved her. Okay. Yeah, but I just I learned to love because I've been hurt so much. I've experienced pain so much. And I just know it's not a good feeling. So I just really think before I do things. I really think before I speak. And I'm just really happy that I'm more in tune with myself. I'm just really happy that, you know, I am who I am today. I'm just really proud of myself, of who I am, you know? Yeah, so guys, if you would like to see it, you know, just let me know. I would love your feedback. Honestly, I would love your feedback. I hope I did pretty good for my first video. Like I said, my name is Shika. I'm 27 years old. I'm a Sagittarius, December 1st. So, I would like for you guys to like, comment, and subscribe. Like, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and hit the bell button so you can always be notified whenever I put up a video, you know? Just stay in tune with me. Just rock hard with me, you know? You know, you subscribe to me, I'll subscribe back. So, let's get it. Bye.